Hey everyone, it's Angie of the Well-Oiled Life, and thank you so much for joining my little pop-up oil class. I know there's a lot of people who have heard about oils. Maybe you've been kind of watching behind the scenes for a little bit and you're curious about the oils, but you're not exactly sure how you would incorporate them into your daily life. So that's what this class is. I want to kind of give you like a day in the life of and show you just how much you can use these during your day. I've been oiling for about 4 years, and I cannot imagine not having my oils. It was funny, this morning I was thinking about the fact, I think it was probably, I don't know, maybe 2 years ago or so, but there was like a pretty serious tornado warning, and we had to wake the kids out of bed, and we had to bring them in the basement, and the three things I brought was my family, my photo albums, and my oils. Like, I was like, if something happens to the house, like, we need our oils. So they are a huge part of our life, and I'm really not sure what we would do without them. So, but I know if you're on the other side and you're just hearing about oils and seeing them, and you're like, I don't know what I would do with those. I don't know if I would use those. So I want to just show you some really practical ways that we use them in our daily life. So, the first thing I want to say is that, and if you've been following anybody who talks about Young Living for any length of time, you'll know that not all oils are created equally. So kind of think of it like your food. Think of it like the labels on food. Some of those labels are regulated and some of them aren't. Like things on food can say all natural and they can say a variety of things, but there's really no regulation for some of those terms. And like for instance, if you know that you want to buy, I'm just going to give an example, beef from a cow that was, you know, raised on grass and pastured land, that's a whole lot different than, you know, another type of beef. But by looking at the label, you might not know because there's some terms that just are not very strictly regulated. And so you really need to know, if you really want to know where your beef's coming from, you kind of got to know your farmer. You may even visit the farm and see how he's raising the animals. The same is true for your oils. So, you know, thankfully, you know, even when I started 4 years ago, oils were not all that popular. It was only in the last, I would say, 2 to maybe 3 years that they really started being recognized as a way to keep your family well. And so that's great because I think a lot more people are open to using oils for their family. But at the same time, there's been a lot of, I'm just going to call them imposters, right, that have popped up. And you'll see now oils at the store that say, you know, 100% natural, or they'll even say, I even saw somewhere recently I was out and about and it said therapeutic grade on it. And the oil was like $6.99. Like, I know that that's not a that oil is not going to compare to Young Living's in any way, shape, or form. That's just how it is. So it's the same with the food example I gave. You really have to know where your oils are coming from, how they were produced, and that's why Young Living, that's what their seed-to-seal process is all about. So they have, you know, they kind of watch over the production of the oils from the seed in the ground all the way to the seal. So you can visit Young Living's farms. You can watch the oils be distilled. These oils get tested to make sure they have all of the right components that they're supposed to have before they even get bottled. So Young Living takes their quality very, very seriously. And as excited as I get when I'm at the store and see essential oils all over now and people are trying to turn to some more natural ways to support their health, it's a little bit disheartening when you see them that are, you know, that they were very cheaply produced and they could be filled with synthetics. They could be heated and have no therapeutic properties at all. They could have fillers in them. They could have been extracted with chemicals. There's all kinds of things that the label's not going to tell you. So you really, just like with the, you know, the farm and knowing like where the animals are coming from, it's the same with oils. And so for myself, we definitely trust the quality of Young Living just based on the fact that they put so much effort into making that they have pure oil. So I first wanted to get that out of the way, that I firmly believe Young Living's oils are very, very, very different than what you might find if you just like pop into the local drugstore, okay? So I just wanted to say that. Okay, so let's get to the meat of what we're going to talk about. And this is going to be, like, on a given day, what might you do with your oils? So Young Living has well over 150 oils, I think, at this point. But I'm going to mainly focus on oils in the Premium Starter Kit just because that's the kit most people start with. And I just want to give you a good idea of what you might do with those oils. Saying that, there are oils outside of the kit that I use very frequently, and so I probably will mention a few of those. But I will try to focus on those oils to give you a good idea. So let's start off with Thieves Oil. So Thieves Oil, if you don't know about oils, you may have heard of this one just because of the fact it's an extremely popular oil, this time of year especially. So Thieves Vitality Oil, which is an oil that is labeled for internal consumption, it can support healthy respiratory function. So this time of year, we hear a lot about Thieves. You can take Thieves Vitality in a capsule. So let me show you, when I say that, what I'm talking about. You can buy these clear veggie caps, and you can put the Thieves Vitality in there and fill it up with some olive oil, and then take that. And that can help support your respiratory system. You can make Thieves tea, which is really great. We just do like a drop or two of Thieves tea and some honey and some warm water. And again, that's internally for respiratory support. We love Thieves oil. So we actually use that oil a ton this time of year. You can also, the regular Thieves oil, you can diffuse it. And we also rub it on the bottoms of our kids' feet at nighttime. And while we're talking about Thieves, this is where I'm gonna obviously not talk about Premium Starter Kit oils, but there's a whole line of Thieves products that we use this time of year. So again, just ways, everyday ways that I use this for my family. So we have a Thieves spray. I'll carry that I really bring this mostly if I go to a hotel room and I like spray down the remote control and the doorknobs and the light switches and I get grossed out by stuff like that. So there's a Thieves spray that's great this time of year. You can even spray down like your shopping cart handle and things like that if you're out and about. There's a Thieves foaming hand soap, which we love. My daughter has really sensitive skin on her hands. The soap at school actually makes her like skin crack and bleed. So her skin's really sensitive, but this soap she does amazing with. So we love it. And this is just part of the Thieves line. They have if you're looking to really start getting rid of harmful chemicals in your home, they even have a Thieves laundry detergent and a Thieves cleaner. And I don't want to spend too much time on this, but I have to tell you this story. So 2 days ago, I was trying to make homemade soap. I mean, seriously, who am I? Anyways, I had to melt all this coconut oil. It was like 33 ounces of coconut oil. So that's like, I don't know, what is that? 4 cups or something? And long story short, the glass thing I was melting it in exploded and 4 cups of liquid coconut oil got like all over my kitchen, my stovetop, my countertop, down the front of my cabinets, all over the floor. And I was able, it's so funny because I don't know if you can see this. You probably can. It's right here. It probably started like right here. It only took me like that much Thieves cleaner. Like the degreasing power of this Thieves cleaner is amazing. So as you can see, I use these products every single day, in my home, but again, outside of the kit, but I did want to mention it because there is a whole Thieves line. There's also, and I don't have them with me, they have Thieves cough drops, which are newer to the product line, which we use those this time of year as well, you know, for sore throats and coughs. We love those. And there's also a Thieves hand purifier. I have that. It's just, I forgot to bring it up here with me. But we love the Thieves products. So I think if nothing else, I would use Young Living just for the Thieves line. But thankfully, there's a ton more products. So moving on. So obviously, I think I have beat that horse dead with a Thieves line because we really do use it all the time. But I'm going to move on to RC. And we love RC. You know, it's so funny. This time of year, like the air gets so dry. At least I live in Indiana and it's just the heater's on a lot of the time, and the air gets so, so dry from the furnace. And so I love RC, like spread it on your chest or on your sinuses or even in the diffuser. We use this oil all the time this time of year. And then we also use this. You can use RC before you exercise. Again, you can use it the same way. You can even diffuse it, put it on your chest, but you'll just be amazed like how deeply you can breathe if you put RC on. So you can use this, like if you wake up in the morning and you're exercising, pull out your RC, put some on, and then afterwards, if you have like tight muscles, or if you've been sitting at a desk all day long, Panaway is one of our favorites, and sometimes I even will use peppermint with my Panaway. Either afterwards, I'll either layer them or you can mix them together. But these are oils that we use all the time. I use these daily. They come out of my stash every single day. So those are definitely our favorites, and those are all in the original kit I was telling you about as well that most people start with. So. Moving on, let's say you are at an office lunch or maybe you go to dinner and you eat a really heavy meal. Digize Vitality and Peppermint Vitality in a capsule are like amazing to take after eating a big meal. So Peppermint Vitality really helps to maintain proper digestion, so we love to use it for that reason. I'm going to show you really quick. Hopefully, I say really quick and it's not going to be, but I'm going to try. I'm going to show you how to fill a capsule so you know how you might take this. Again, for me, I wouldn't say this is a daily occurrence that I need to take this, but definitely multiple times a week, I would say I use some Digize and some Digize Vitality and Peppermint Vitality. So I'm going to try to see if you can see me fill this, but you just drip them in. I do like two or three drops. That was Digize Vitality. This is Peppermint Vitality, and then I just have a bottle of olive oil, and I take that, and I top it off with the olive oil, and that will dilute it. So these oils are super, super, super potent, and so I always like to dilute these when I'm making them for internal consumption, and then you just swallow this like a pill with water, and I'm mad that I don't have water, otherwise I would take this. I'll have to save it for later. Anyways, but we use those oils very frequently, like I said. So, yes. Okay, let's move on. Let's talk about this time of year with it being stressful, with just Christmas, and I have the added, I'm sure some of you do too, but I have the added pressure. My daughter's birthday is like 2 weeks before Christmas. So that always gets a little bit stressful this time of year. And every year I tell myself I'm going to plan better. And every year I feel stressed out. So this is one of my favorite oils this time of year. And it is Stress Away. And really it's one of my favorite all-time oils anyways. But it smells good. It has vanilla in it and lime in it and a few other things. But sometimes if I'm just like really stressed out, you can just breathe it, just smell it out of the bottle, just take a few deep breaths and you can just feel yourself kind of start to relax a little bit. When I'm putting this on, I'll just put on like a drop or two on my wrist and just spread it on almost like you would perfume. And then, I'll either take the extra or put another drop and like just kind of rub it on the back of my neck. And, I love this oil. I use it straight out of the bottle. You can dilute it if you want to. They also make this in a roll-on, but the one that comes in the kit is this bottle. So we use this all the time. And then during the day, like when I'm working, obviously work from home, but I am like a crazy person about diffusing oils during the day. I love it. So this is the diffuser that I have. I have actually several of them. This is just one of them. But there's a ton of combinations that you can diffuse. So for instance, like to purify the air, I love to use purification and lavender essential oils. And this just really, like if you've cooked or made dinner or something and there's just lingering smell, it will get the smell out of the air. I just really like how it smells. So a lot of times I'll just diffuse that. While we're talking about diffusing, this time of year, I love Christmas spirit. I think it smells like mulled cider. I think like orange and cinnamon and spruce. I would have to look. I'm pretty sure those three are in it, but I think it smells amazing. And I'm just telling you about this one because right now, if you are a new person and you've never used oils and you enroll with this premium kit, Young Living will send you a free bottle of Christmas spirit. It's a small bottle. This is the large one, but this will send you a free 5 milliliter bottle. But again, this is one of my favorites to diffuse this time of year. I love it. There's tons of combos that I like to make. There's ones, some of them I just make them because they smell good, and I just will make sure that my diffuser's on while I'm working. Some of them are like, you know, I'm just trying to maybe address a certain issue, and so I'll pick oils a little bit more specifically. In that instance, we diffuse oils at night, every night in our kids' rooms. I think I showed you this RC. Right now, this time of year, our combo is RC and lavender. I put that both in both of my kids' rooms at night. But, yes, Christmas spirit, there's one other. Oh, stress away and lemon is another combo that smells really good. Like I said, there's a whole bunch. We actually just came up with an entire list of diffuser recipes just using the premium starter kit that are super awesome. So there's a ton of things that you can do with the kit oils. Okay, so that's diffusing. The other thing you could do, and of course I don't have it, but I have, you can buy little metal spray bottles or glass spray bottles, and you can create your own room sprays. So, I don't know if you use Febreze or any products like that, but there's really a lot of nasty ingredients in those things. And especially this time of year where we're not getting a lot of fresh air inside of our homes, we don't typically have the windows open when it's, 30 and 40 degrees out. All that stuff stays trapped in your home. So essential oils are a great solution for that. And there's a lot of times where, even if we've cooked something and I want to like get back down the hallways and stuff like that, like I'll just get my spray bottle out. I'll make up a combo that I think smells nice and I'll just start spraying away. And honestly, I don't even need that much oil for that. I might use like 5 drops of 2 different oils, maybe 10 drops total, and maybe fill it with like 4 to 8 ounces of water and just spray it, and you have your own homemade room spray. So again, these are all ways that we use our oils every single day. They pretty much permeate our existence, I would say. I know that sounds crazy, but they really do. One thing about the room spray, this is just a little tip if you do make them. I also include some Epsom salt in there, and that helps the oils stay mixed in. I still do shake it before I spray it, but that helps them stay mixed in a little bit more. Another thing I want to tell you what you can do. I haven't experimented a ton with this. There is one recipe I will tell you about that I do use very frequently, but Young Living has a very extensive line of vitality oils. And so the vitality are labeled for internal use. Now I will tell you, the vitality oil and the regular oil are the exact same oil in the bottle. It's just the way that they've been labeled. So anyways, they have these whole line of vitality oils, again, for internal use, that you can cook with and you can experiment cooking with. I was recently at a Young Living retreat and it was really awesome. We were eating, they had made the food with some of the oils, which again is just not something I've messed around with or experimented with a whole lot. But they had, I think it was broccoli, I don't know, some sort of vegetable, and they had the black pepper vitality in the broccoli, and it was so good. I was like, what is in this? Like, these are really good. I've never tasted anything like this before. And someone said, oh yeah, there's black pepper vitality oil. And I was like, that is a really good idea. So if you like to cook in the kitchen and you like to experiment, you can use the oils in that way as well. The one thing I do consistently use my peppermint oil for is I love to make my own mochas. So I'll just take a cup of coffee and I'll pour in like maybe 1/4 cup of almond milk. You can use whatever kind of milk you want. And then I take some cacao powder, which if you don't have that, you could use cocoa powder. But I put that and I put like a dash of maple syrup and I put 1 or 2 drops of peppermint vitality and I like mix it up. You can either use like an immersion blender or if you have like a magic bullet or a ninja or something like that, blend it up and it gets frothy even. And it is really awesome. So I, again, another use every day, that I just incorporate them because I love them so much for everything. Okay, I've covered a lot of the oils in the kit. The next one I want to tell you about, so let's just pretend we've gone about our day, right? We've woken up, we've exercised. One thing I don't think I told you about is you can put them in your water. So we all know we should be drinking more water. There's a ton of vitality oils that are great in your water. Peppermint, lemon, orange. There's a bunch that you can mix in and it really can help you drink more water. I've been trying to make a more concerted effort over the last month to drink more water. Just never very thirsty, so it's hard for me to get to drink to remember to drink. But I find that when I have a flavor in there, that it really helps me get more water in. So that's another use for the Vitality oils. Okay, so let's go back to our day, right? We've woken up, we've exercised, we've used our pan away and our C. We've had our water with our oils in it. Maybe we've had a heavy meal. We've taken our peppermint and our Digize Vitality. If we're stressed during the day, we could put some stress away on or some lavender. That's one I didn't mention, but lavender is great at just relaxing you and making you feel calm down a little bit. Maybe we're working and we have our diffuser going. You know, they have smaller diffusers. If you do work in an office, you can get a smaller diffuser and diffuse your oils. They can just really help to purify the air and just, you know, bring a good nice scent around, but they're great for air purification. We talked about making room sprays and things like that. Again, these are things that we do all the time. Again, you can cook with them. That kind of takes us to the bedtime routine, right? And frankincense is really great for your skin. It's funny, I was talking to a lady just recently, a couple weeks ago, and she said she got her kit and she had started using frankincense in her night cream. So really, you would just, like, if it's a pump lotion, for instance, you would put your lotion, do a drop of frankincense, and smooth it on your skin. And she was like, I've been doing that for a few weeks, she said, and people are commenting that my skin looks glowing. And she said, I think it's a frankincense. It's the only thing I've changed. So I love this oil. It's funny, I didn't used to love how it smelled at the beginning. If you grew up in a church that burned incense, that's kind of what it smells like. But I've really grown to love it. I like the smell of it now. But it is a stronger smell, but I think it works great. So. And frankincense does come in the kit. But so we're going to bed, we've got our frankincense on our skin, and then my very last favorite way to end the day is to just put some oils on before going to bed. So I love Stress Away. I think I am a must be a stressed out person, because when I put this on, it like instantly calms me and allows me to fall asleep. I think my mind is always running in a million directions, and Stress Away just gives me just really can calm my mind down and allow me to fall asleep. Lavender is another favorite for bedtime. You can, either of these oils, you can put on your wrists, you can put on the back of your neck like I showed you. Some people will put them in a diffuser before they go to bed and start their diffuser like 30 minutes before they go up. And that way, once they are in their room's already kind of, you know, filled with this calming smell to help them fall asleep better. And so yeah, that's kind of a day in the life. I mean, that might sound like a lot of oils that I use in my day, and it probably kind of is, but I mean, that's no joke. Like, we use them all the time. From putting them on the kids' feet, I'll rub them on their chest. You know, sometimes my daughter might come home from school and be like, Mom, I need some peppermint on my head, or Mom, I think I need some peppermint on my belly. The kids know to ask for oils because they know how amazing they feel when we use them. So that's kind of like my morning to night routine. And I want to tell you just a couple other ideas of how you might use them. There are a lot of supplements that Young Living has. This is one of my favorites, Mineral Essence. I actually did a video on this the other day if you want to scroll back and watch it. But they have a ton of essential oil infused supplements, and their quality is great. So I just wanted to mention that's a whole nother line if you want to ever browse around and look. But I just wanted to mention that in case you didn't know. I wanted to also show you that you can make your own roll-ons. So sometimes we do this. So for instance, let's say you really love the combination of Stress Away and lavender at night. You can get like an empty bottle. I just always use my old bottles, but you can order bottles. But I will fill them up. Like, I might put maybe 10 drops of one and 10 drops in another, and then fill the rest up with a carrier oil. So a carrier oil could be like an almond, a jojoba oil, olive oil. Young Living has a V6 oil. You'd fill it up, put a roller on the top, and then that way you're all set to just roll this on before bed. So you could make your own custom mixes and use these. And it's really fun to experiment. Again, we just came up with a whole bunch of ideas just for the Premium Starter Kit oils. There's tons of things you can do with it. Roll-on recipes, diffuser recipes, and capsule recipes. So this, you know, these guys are so, so versatile. Even if you don't, like I said, there's 150 of them. Even if you just have a handful of them, or if you get the kit with 11 oils, like there's a ton of things that you will use them for in your day. What else did I want to tell you? I'm just going to share with you a couple other of my favorite products really briefly. I showed you all the Thieves line, which clearly I'm sold on the Thieves line because I have almost all the products. Tranquil Roll-On. I love this one. Sometimes I'll switch back and forth between my Stress Away at Night and Tranquil at Night. I love this blend. It has cedar wood in it, which is really great for sleep as well. And then this time of year, I kind of use this interchangeably with RC, but this is Breathe Again. And so I'll just roll it over like sinuses, over the chest, over the back of the neck. And we love Breathe Again. I have to use this frequently on my son at night before he goes to bed. So I think that is all I wanted to tell you guys. I didn't want to take too much of your time and make this class too long, but I really wanted to show you that, like, you can use these for a lot of different things in your everyday life, and we do. I mean, I know this is a business for me, which is why I have the guts to get on here and talk to you live and with everything that could go wrong. But if this was not a business for me, I would still be using every single product I just showed you here just because it's what we need. I mean, it's what we use. This is our wellness cabinet right here. And we use these every day. So don't be scared to use them. I think some people get them and get intimidated, but they are very, very easy to use. They're pretty hard to mess up. And we just think that they are amazing. So anyways, if you're new, if you're considering oils and have questions, I would love to answer them for you. If you, if you end up wanting to join a team, we have a great team of people, and I promise I will take good care of you. We have a ton of resources to get you started and learning. But yeah, if you have questions, please post them below. I will be watching this thread and making sure that I answer any questions. And I appreciate you so much that you've taken time to watch this. I hope it was helpful in some way. All right, thanks, guys.